Hello guys, welcome to Smart Horizon. I'm Bhavna Chawla. In this tutorial, we will be learning what filters are and what are blending modes. You can use filters to clean up or retouch your photos. Or you can apply special artifacts that gives your image the appearance of a sketch or a painting. And you can do much more with filters. The filters provided by Adobe appear in the filter menu here. This is the filter menu. So here we open a raster image and a vector image. We will be first applying filters to the raster image. So here we have our raster image. To apply a filter, we will go to filters. And scroll down to filter gallery. This pop-up window has wide range of filters that I can apply. On the left I have the preview of the filter applied. On the right we have the filter categories. Here we can choose quite a range of filters. If we click on these arrows, these are the filters. As we click, you can see the preview of the filter applied here. These are the categories, different categories. Over the far right, we have the filter values. We can toggle between them to have a different result. As you can see here in the preview. After the effect is final, click OK. And see the main document. It has also changed in the same way. So we applied a filter to a raster image here. It's easy. I'll now apply a different filter to this image. First, I'll undo the filter here and I'll again go to filter. This time, I'll click on Gaussian blur. I'll go to filter, scroll down to blur and click on Gaussian blur. Here I can change the value. After finalizing, I'll press OK. I'll undo it again. Next, I'll apply sharpen. This is sharpen. It will help you if you have small amount of blurriness in any image. I'll undo this too. I will now apply pixelate and scroll down to mosaic. You can change the value as you want. My image looks pixelated. I'll click OK. But if I save this image, there will be no coming back as we are working on raster image. So be cautious using filters this way. Now we will apply filters to a smart layer. We will select the layer on which we have our smart object, that is the vector image. Go to filters and apply a blur. Gaussian blur. Here you can see the changes when I increase or decrease the value of the radius. I'll press OK. Now if we see on the layer panel, we have smart filters applied. This is our smart filter. Here we can click on the eye to hide the filter effect. If I don't want to see this effect, I can even hide this effect. I can even edit it by double clicking on the filter name. We can also apply as much filters as we want. Like on this layer, if I want another filter, I'll go to filter, pixelate and mosaic. I'll press OK. So here now we have two filters applied. If I remove blur, it removes the blurness. And if I remove mosaic, this is what we see. So now you have the idea why we should work more on smart objects in Photoshop. Next is our blending modes. For that, I'll close this document and I have this document now. Blending modes are used to blend two layers. Here we have this document. In this document, we have an image layer that has the object, if we see, a layer which has crushed paper texture, and a layer with a gradient. In the layer panel, it's written normal here. If we click on this arrow, we have this menu here. As you can see, this menu is divided into five different categories. The first is darken modes, second is lighten modes, third category is of contrast modes, fourth is comparative mode, and the last is composite mode. Now I'll hide this gradient layer here. I'll click on the paper texture layer and I'll decrease the opacity. But this does not seem like these layers are blending. So we drag opacity to 100%. And we change the blending mode to multiply in the darken modes. Now if I apply multiply, you can see this is perfect. So we will now try another blending mode and scroll down to overlay. As it belongs to the contrast mode, it looks a lot brighter. I'll again apply multiply. Now I'll change the blending mode of the gradient layer to have the gradient effect on these two layers. I'll change this blending mode to screen here and decrease a small amount of opacity to have a less brighter image. This is it. So you can create a lot of visual effects using blending modes. Keep practicing. Thank you for watching. If you like my video, kindly press the like button and subscribe to my channel. Don't forget to press the bell icon so that you get notified when I upload new content. Thank you for watching.